there's a lot of factors that contribute to addiction, and many people in this world, people you may not even know, have struggled with it. So taking up down the stigma and breaking down that wall that surrounds addiction and viewing it as a mental illness is probably the best thing moving forward and treating it, as well as possibly even curing it one day.
So in our lab, we study how drugs affect the brain and behavior. One of our research questions is how drugs affect the adolescent brain differently than it affects the adult brain.
One of the categories that we've examined is the opioids. And a lot of people may be familiar with the opioids because of the current epidemic of prescription opioid abuse, and that leading to people using heroin. And so gaining a better understanding of the opioids, we're able to get a better understanding of how they affect the brain and how the use of these might lead to addiction.
So in the lab, I focused on how drugs like Ritalin affects adolescents differently than it affects adults. Ritalin is one of the leading pharmacological treatments for ADHD, and you see children as young as 3 on the drugs, and this can actually make individuals more susceptible to drug addiction. So I think it's really important that we find out what sort of effects are occurring on children and how that will affect their health and just their behavior in the future.
Some of the work we've done in our lab with opioids points to tolerance and sensitization, which are two phenomena in drug addiction that are very powerful. So understanding the perception of pleasure that they feel from these drugs will provide the most benefits for the drug abuse field.
We're getting a better understanding about the pleasurable effects of drugs and something called neuroplasticity, or how the drugs change the brain and therefore change behavior that can more likely lead to addiction. And in fact, some of the work we have going on has examined the potential for certain drugs to decrease the neuroplasticity in response to opioids. And so we're able to prevent some of the processes that lead to addiction with particular drugs. The discoveries that we make certainly can eventually impact on the prevention and treatment of a variety of things, including drug abuse and addiction, depression, schizophrenia, and other psychiatric disorders.